Right, welcome back to my studio. I'm continuing this Palomino horse I studied before, and I'll be changing a little bit in this painting today. First of all, I'm going to darken the background. So I'm painting on 8x10 linen canvas panel, and I'm using titanium white, cadmium lemon yellow, permanent rose, and ultramarine blue. These are my primary color of the day. My primary colors change depending on the day and the project that I'm working on. And I already mixed my custom black from these three primaries. So I'm going to utilize this dark color. I'm going to add a little bit of medium. And this, there's a little bit of gray left over from last session. So I'm just gonna recycle this paint. I was storing my palette with this mixed paint in the freezer overnight. I'm going to use a big brush, relatively big one, for this project. This is number 6 flat Robert Simmons Signet brush. That's hog hair. So it's pretty stiff and it's easy to move the paint around. I already had warm and lighter colors in the background, so I'm trying not to cover everything like house paint, because I wanna be able to see this under painting color between this brush stroke. And I might bring back this texture with palette knife later. Also, carving out the shape of the horse, what I'm adding the background. I think by darkening the background, it will push this forehead a little more forward. I'm not 100% certain if this new color will work, so I'm gonna be checking a little bit later, see if I actually like it. I'm not trying to copy the reference image exactly with the same color. I'm going for my impressionistic style, so I'm layering different interesting colors to create more visual interest. If you are watching this live, I'd like to know where you're watching this from. You can type and talk to me through the chat. Also, correcting the shape of his hand neck. Her name is Laura. So we call her Princess Laura, Princess Pony. It comes in a little bit more like this. I'm trying to keep the edges pretty soft and loose away from her face, because I don't want to call too much attention to the hard edges away from the center of interest, which is her face. So everything else has very soft edges. But this edge is pretty hard edge. So it looks like it's in front of this war. There's a big opening in this barn behind her forehead, but I'm pretending as if the entire barn has this light. The silver, what do you call it? Silver corrugated wall. Might make this a little bit darker. Maybe a little bit more desaturated. With yellow, which is a complementary color. Just gonna put this right here as my standby color, so that I don't have to keep wiping my brush with paper towel to reach out more. Yellow. test this. Okay, that's definitely too much yellow. I think that's more like it. So the medium I'm using today is called Sorbent Free Gel. It's made by Gambling. Depending on the project, I also use liquin, but liquin tends to smell a lot more, and I live in Central Washington State, so it's getting quite chilly outside. Like, I have all the windows and the door closed, so I don't have a great ventilation here. So I don't want to use very very smelly stuff. Just scumbling this on top of this violet. Carving out the shape of the ears with background color. Just double checking the placement of the ear, because I've been shifting the edges of the ear. So sometimes, even if I use grid method to draw the big shapes initially, my my drawing can get out of control after a while. Especially after, once I start putting thick paint on the canvas. Creating a little bit darker version of this. I want to keep the corners darker so that it has this vignette effect. Not everything is straight line, so I'm creating this organic shape. Throughout the painting. That's part of the reason I'm so drawn to paint animals. Because of these beautiful organic shapes with the nice lighting effect on them. We have 14 chickens and 4 ducks. They are free ranging in the backyard, and every time I walk by them, I'm so happy to see their pear-shaped bodies in the sunlight or even the overcast light. Maybe it's getting so much glare on the canvas. Okay, I think I'm gonna make the corners even darker. Ah. I may not like it, but I have to test it and see if it's going to work or not. I'm sitting on the office chair behind the webcam, so I'm walking around this webcam. So you're watching this as if I'm looking at canvas. I'm starting to like it. It's better. Maybe darker the better. I think by darkening the background, I can see the value relationship of the foreground a little bit better. But I might have to go back and make adjustments, and that's okay. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer. If you can just put your questions in the comment, in the chat, if you are watching this live. Now let's see what happens if I layer this lighter version with palette knife. My favorite part of the painting. I'm going to switch my hand to left hand. Let's see what. It's hard to reach. All right, this will work. Because I'm right-handed, I have better control with the right hand. Now I can create another version of this, maintaining the value. Okay. Maybe I'll create more cyan. So if you're just joining me, I'm just using three primary colors plus titanium white. And my three primary colors today is cadmium lemon yellow, permanent rose, and ultramarine blue. So ultramarine blue and permanent rose are transparent. Time to wipe my palette knife. Okay. Just gonna leave it in a spare standby section, and I'm gonna just add a little by little. I'm gonna keep this in a similar value range so that this texture has visual interest, but it doesn't jump out. I have a feeling that this may be too dark, but I don't know. Yeah, it's too dark. And I don't know. Maybe I'm gonna make this one notch lighter. Just like the silver corrugated metal on the side wall, on the siding. What you call siding of the barn? Yeah, something like that. Kind of blending and not blending on the canvas. If I don't like it, I can scrape it off. Just being goofy. Can you guys hear me okay? If you could tell me if you can hear me or not, I would so appreciate it. So because the direction of the corrugated metal is vertical, I want to mimic that direction. And I don't want to make it too warm. Not too bad. I don't want to overblend it. See, like instead of I'm standing behind the webcam stand so that I can use my entire arm. Actually, like painting with shoulder rather than with my wrist. So I can move my hand better. Maybe I can bring this back a little bit. See, if I scrape a little bit harder, it reveals the underpainting of a warm purple. I'm desaturating this even more. So it's almost like muted dark gray here. More medium. Kind of doing abstract painting with palette knife. I don't have to worry about details. Just having fun. It's pretty relaxing. Because at the end of the day, I don't care how this will turn out. It's not like I'm doing this for the deadline of some juried show or competition or anything like that. No pressure. I'm starting to like this with darker corners, really starting to push back the background. So I have my reference image displayed on my tablet on the left side of my easel. I think I want to keep this area a little bit warmer and lighter. See, the sunlight is coming from the left side, so I want to keep this side warmer. Let's see. What happens if I put anything like this? I don't know. Maybe too strong. Okay, we'll combine with this neutral color. Kind of going wild here. That's this speckles of red. Will kind of relate or harmonize the warm light on her face and the background a little bit. Get rid of this dark. And there are some warm brown in the background. I see warm orange down here. Let's see, maybe I'll make this lighter. Can't reach down there, so I have to be creative. Adding more permanent rose. The strong reflected light from the ground. I may not like it, but I can always scrape it and paint over because it's oil paint. Now I can modify this background color to create light cyan. I'm trying not to blend this too much because I don't want to create green by mixing the yellow and light blue. I want to create some gradation. From the right edge toward the center. So changing the value. All right, time to clean my hands with baby wipe. I use baby wipe to clean my hands when I'm like in the studio. It cleaned my hands pretty well, seem covered with paint, but see? It's clean again. Come on, sit back and enjoy my painting. checking where I am. Sorry about the glare, but there's nothing, not much I can do because the dark paint tends to be really glary. Okay. Now, see what I can do with this. Fixing my drawing here. think I need a cleaner version of the cyan. Oops. Still darker than the lit part. So maybe I just need to darken the whole thing. I want to adjust the value before adjusting the temperature. needs to be darker. Yeah. Reflected light of the blue sky here. So it's not completely black. I'm gonna add back the highlight here later. Now, I've been thinking about putting this harder soon, so it's gonna be like this. I think I'm going to do this part tomorrow when the paint is a little bit dry. But in the meantime, I'm going to work on this edge. I'm running out of mixing space on the left side of the palette, so I'm using the right side where you cannot see. Just gonna wipe this away. Need more mixing area. This is just a regular razor blade with nice big handle. So I can scrape away all the paint very easily, especially when it's so nice and soft. Even if it's completely dry, this razor blade is my best friend. And cleaning my hands with baby wipe. When I move my palette onto the table so I can work on the horseback. Something like that. If I don't like it, I can paint over. see if I can create the mane here. I think I need to wait until this paint, background paint, settles in a little bit. So I'm just gonna put this back here and let it settle down a little bit overnight. It's kind of way overdue for my dinner time, so. Yeah, it's impossible to work on this because everything is so wet. Just gonna put this back. That. Just want to soften this edge so it doesn't leave anything harsh. I should be using bigger brush. This isn't working. All right, I'm gonna take a break here and go get dinner. Thank you for watching and have a good evening. Bye.